In this video, I want to do some examples looking at distributions, in particular, different features in distributions, like clusters, gaps, and peaks. So over here, I want to do it with some examples. Which of the following are accurate descriptions of the distribution below? Select all that apply. So the first statement is, the distribution has an outlier. So an outlier is a data point that's way off of where the other data points are. It's way larger or way smaller than where all of the other data points seem to be clustered. And if we look over here, we have a lot of data points between 0 and 6. And just let's think about what they're measuring. This is shelf time for each apple at Gorge's Grocer. So for example, we see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 apples that have a shelf life of 0 days. So they're about to go bad. You see you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 apples that are going to be good for another day. You have 2 apples that are going to be good for another 6 days. And you have 1 apple that's going to be good for 10 days. And this is unusual. This is an outlier here. It has a way larger shelf life than all of the other data. So I would say this definitely does have an outlier. We just have this one data point sitting all the way to the right, way larger, way more shelf life than everything else. So it definitely has an outlier, and this one would be the outlier. The distribution has a cluster from 4 to 6 days. And we indeed do see a cluster from 4 to 6 days. A cluster, you can imagine, it's a grouping of data that's sitting there, or you have a grouping of apples that have a shelf life between 4 and 6 days, and you definitely do see that cluster there. And since I already selected 2 things, I'm definitely not going to select none of the above. So let me check my answer. Let me do a few more of these. Which of the following are accurate descriptions of the distribution below? And once again, we're going to select all that apply. So the distribution has an outlier. So let's see, this distribution, I do have a data point here that's at the high end, and I have another data point here that's at the low end, but I don't have any data points that are sitting far, far above or far below the bulk of the data. If I had a data point that was out here, then yeah, I would say that was an outlier to the right or a positive outlier. If I had a data point way to the left off the screen over here, maybe that would be an outlier, but I don't really see any obvious outliers. All of the data, it's pretty clustered together. So I would not say that the distribution has an outlier. The distribution has a peak at 22 degrees. Yeah, it does indeed look like we have, and let's just look at what we're actually measuring, high temperature each day in Edgerton, Iowa in July. So it does indeed look like we have the most number of days that had a high temperature at 22 degrees Celsius. So that is a peak, and you can see it. If you imagine this is kind of a mountain, this is a peak right here. This is a high point. You have at least locally, you have the most number of days at 22 degrees Celsius. So I would say it definitely has a peak there. Since I selected something, I'm not going to select none of the above. Let's do a couple more of these. Which of the following are accurate descriptions of the distribution below? So the first one, the distribution has an outlier. So let's see, this number of guests by day at Seth's Sandwich Shop. So let's see, they have no days where he had between 0 and 19 guests. No days where he had between 20 and 39 guests. Looks like there's about 9 days where he had between 40 and 59 guests. Looks like 20 days where he had between 60 and 79 guests. All the way that it looks like this is maybe 8 days that he had between 180 and 199 guests. But in the question of outliers, there doesn't seem to be any day where he had an unusual number of guests. There's not a day that's, you know, way out here where he had like 500 guests. So I would say this distribution does not have an outlier. The distribution has a cluster from 0 to 39 guests. So 0 to 39 guests is right over here, 0 to 39 guests. And there's no days where he had between 0 and 39 guests, either 0 to 19 or 20 to 39. So there's definitely not a cluster there. I would say that the cluster would be were days that had between 40 and 199 guests. Definitely not 0 and 39. There was no days that were between 0 and 39 guests. So I would say none of the above, very confidently. Let's do one more of these. Which of the following are accurate descriptions of the distribution below? All right, the distribution has a peak from 12 to 13 points. Let me see what this is measuring or what this data is about. Test scores by student in Miss Frein's class. So you had one student who got between a 0 and a 1 on on a 20-point scale, so got between, I guess you maybe out of 20 questions, got it between 0 and 1 point. And then you see that there's no students got between 2 and 3, or 4 and 5, or 6 and 7. Then we have another student who got between 8 and 9. Looks like 3 students got between 10 and 11. And then we keep increasing. This looks like it's about 12 students got either a 16 or a 17, or something in between, maybe if you could get decimal points, on that test. And then it looks like 10 students got from 18 to 19. All right, so this says the distribution has a peak from 12 to 13 points. 12 to 13 points, there were 5 students, but this isn't a peak. If you just go to 14 to 15 points, you have more students. So this is definitely not a peak. If you were looking at this as a mountain of some kind, you definitely wouldn't describe this point as a peak. You would say this distribution has a peak, has the most number of students who got between 16 and 17 points. So that's the peak right there, not 12 to 13 points. So I would not select that first choice. The distribution has an outlier. Well, yeah, look at this. You have this outlier. Most of the students scored between 8 and 19 points. And then you have this one student who got between 0 and 1. It's really an outlier. You even see this, you know, when you look at it visually, it's not even connected to the rest of the distribution. It's way to the left. If something's way to the left or way to the right, that's an outlier. If it's a kind of unusually low or unusually high. So I would say this distribution definitely does have an outlier. And I'm not going to pick none of the above since I found a choice. And I think we're all done.